kuabudiwa, wa kuinuliwa ni wewe. Wa kuabudiwa, wa kuinuliwa ni wewe. Oh! Hey! 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 Shada da bahane. Wakupewa sifa na utukufu na heshima ni wewe, wenye nguvu na uweza ni wewe. Wakupewa sifa, utukufu, mamlaka ni wewe, wenye nguvu na uweza ni wewe. Wakupewa sifa, wakupewa sifa
na utukufu na heshima ni wewe, wenye nguvu na uweza ni wewe.
Wakupewa sifa, tukuinulia mioyo yetu Bwana. Hakuna aliye kama wewe Jehova, hakuna linganishaye na wewe Bwana, hauna mpinzani. Siele mama yana mama, wakupewa sifa, utukufu na uweza ni wewe, mwenye nguvu na uweza ni wewe. Wakupewa sifa, utukufu, heshima, mamlaka ni wewe. Tukinulia mikono yetu Bwana wa mabwana, washa moyo wako ja ibada. Inulia mikono yako ni sauti yako. Hele! Mwenye nguvu na uweza. Wakupewa sifa. Wakupewa sifa. Wakupewa ibada. Wakupewa utukufu. Bwana, tunainua mikono yetu kwako. Inua mikono yako kama una mikono, mwinulie Yesu. Umekuja kumwabudu Bwana Yesu, mwabudu yeye. Mpe yeye utukufu anayestahili. Ele maya ndaya ndaramereba. Unaweza kuchagua kumwabudu yeye aliye na uhai na uzima wako.
Haleluya.
Wakupewa sifa na utukufu na heshima ni wewe, mwenye nguvu na uweza ni wewe.
Worship him now with your own words. Say something to this God. Oh, he's so awesome. God that is so faithful. In the name of Jesus, Say something to him. You are so holy and faithful. You are so holy and mighty. You are so gracious and wonderful. You reign from everlasting to everlasting. Thank you because of your presence. Thank you because of your glory. Thank you because you are the God of the living. You are not the God of the dead. We thank you for the word that is coming our way. Transform our thinking. Change our lives in a permanent way. This we pray in Jesus' name. This we pray in Jesus' name. Somebody shout a big amen. If you have your hands, you can clap them above your head. There is life in the house of God. You can do better than that. You are looking into Jesus, the Son of God. Blessed Father, take all the glory again. Thank you for this service. Men and women whom the Lord you have gathered for yourself. Let the reason of you gathering us be fulfilled today. In Jesus' wonderful name we pray. Are you shouting, yes, Lord? Glory, glory to God. Because I know you cannot greet your neighbor. They are very far. But you can wave at them with your both hands. Now, sio nyamaze sauti haina chochote kibaya. Have you greeted somebody in Jesus' name? Ukiona mtu akusalimi, ushangaa, alafu ushangae tena. Musalimi, ebuko nifaa mtu amekusalimia. Na uzunguke, mikono yako ni nyingi. Mikono yako ni nyingi. Hallelujah. Rejoice then in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Amen. We also welcome those who are watching our services online. Wherever you may be with us as we receive the word of God. God bless you. You can have your seat. And as I told you, make sure you receive the word quickly, very quickly. In the next 30 minutes, you are supposed to have received what God has for you. I thank God for Word Temple Church of God family. I'm told that people did not go to so many churches last Sunday, but I thank God you have come. Let us go to Matthew chapter 22. I am teaching on divine life. Divine life. Ule uzima wa milele. Uzima wa milele. Uhai wa Mungu mwenyewe. And things are going to happen because as I speak, I'm speaking life. And I advise you, those who are not, that is the service that has ended. It is already on Facebook. So make sure after this service, go and watch the service that was before you. And then later, you watch the service that will be next. You attend all of them by wisdom. So Matthew 22. The word of God says in verse 25. Now there were with us. I thank God not here in this church. Now there were with us seven brethren. And the first, when he had married a wife, deceased or died, and having no issue or a child, left his wife unto his brother. I think this man was from Western. Verse 26. Likewise the second also, and the third unto the seventh. Listen, something strange was happening in the life of this woman. Every time she got married, the husband had to die. And that one woman finished the whole family. Seven brothers. All of them, those who got married to this woman, they died. As you receive the word of God today, that which kills others will have no power to kill you. Believe in the word of God. You see, there are businesses when you try to do it, it stops. You begin something and there is no success. Something happens, you lose your business. In this case, in our study here, this woman lost all the seven husbands, and they were brothers. Seven brothers married to one woman, and they all died. We serve a God of life. I say we serve a God of life. May you have it today. You know, as I speak, I'm experiencing something here. So I want you to see all the forces of death, premature death, things that comes to destroy the work of our hands, be finished today. See the power of God intervening. And this case was brought to Jesus in verse 28. The Bible says in verse 27, and the last of all, the woman died also. The woman died after the seven husbands are also dead. Therefore, in the resurrection, whose wife shall she be of the seven? For they all had her. A very powerful question. Wakati tutakapofufuka, mke wa yupi kati ya wale saba? Mke wa nani? Mke wa nani? Very interesting story. Jesus answered and said unto them. What did he say? He said, you error, or you are mistaken, not knowing the scriptures, nor the power of God. Tunakosea, tunafanya makosa. Ama tuapotea kwa kuwa atuyajui maandiko wala uweza wa Mungu. You know, that is very powerful. If you want to lead a stable life, stable life, stable ministry, stable health, combine the knowledge of the scriptures with the knowledge of the power of God. Combine the two. That is what we do in Word Temple Church of God. I teach scriptures, then I give you room to experience the power of God. That is why people error. You lead a spiritual life without the knowledge of the scriptures. Jesus told the Jews who believed in John 8, beginning from verse 30, that yes, The Bible says, and as Jesus spoke these words, many believed on him. Many believed on him. Then he said to them, to the Jews that believed, he said, if you continue, if you do what? Please say it, if you do what? He says, if you continue in my word, then are you my disciples indeed? Then are you my disciples indeed? Then he says, and you shall know the truth, and the truth shall make you free. So, ukika kwa maandiko, uyaelewe maandiko, uelewe neno la Mungu. Then you possess the knowledge of the power of God. You operate beyond error. Say amen. So your whole life can operate on another level. Unaweza maisha yako inaweza fanyia kazi kiwango ambacho akina makosa. And in other words, kiwango ambacho akina mauti. Kiwango ambacho akina mauti kinapatikana wakati umeajua maandiko. Timothy was taught. He was taught, and that from a child you have known the holy scriptures, which are able to make thee wise unto salvation. Salvation is life. They are able to make one wise unto salvation that is in Christ Jesus. Why? Because all scripture is given by inspiration of God. So there is breath of God in the word of God. So these people were asking question. After resurrection, whose wife will she be among the seven men? Then Jesus rejoiced and said, he marveled. They were asking such a question. I want to make it clear to you. You know, these things are in the Bible. The Bible says two people shall be sleeping on one bed. Then one will be taken, the other will be left. You see, there is no marriage in heaven. The reason why people say there are so many challenges in marriage, I will tell you today. Do you know why? You are married to flesh and blood. Nifungie mkono. Umeoa na ukaolewa na damu na mwili. Inaishia hapa. That is why you should never stop moving forward in the things of God because of your wife or because of your husband. Two, hata Bible inasema wawili watakuwa kazini, shambani wakilima, mke na bwanake wanalima. The Bible says one will be taken away, the other one will be left. Siku ya mwisho kutaonekana sinema. Unaweza kuwa umelala na mke wako ufikiria ameenda nje kujisaidia. Hapana, ameenda heaven, umeachwa. Uliolewa na mwili na damu. Hapo kuna kimya. Ulikuwa umefikiria. Don't be deceived by the fancy names people call each other. My angel. Uongo. Ngoja tu, utajua sio malaika akikufa. You are supposed to see far, not where you are now. Jesus was putting things right. Listen what he said here. In verse 30. He said, for in the resurrection, they neither marry nor are given in marriage, but are as the angels of God in heaven. That is why angels don't marry. Ngojea. Oh, soma. So usijidanganye mke wako sio malaika na mume wako sio malaika ndio sababu mumeoana. Amen. Moja tu ndio nimepata kwa kanisa mzima. Ukiona umeshaoa na umeolewa na uko na mpango wa kuja kuoa na kuolewa, hautaoa malaika. Malaika hawaoi. Nifungieni tu mkono na muniwache hapa. Utaoa mtu akusumbue hapa duniani. Nilikuwa naonyesha pasa mmoja anaitwa Samson. Ikimuonyesha hapa Ecclesiastes ya kwamba watu wote waliooa na kuolewa wako na shida. Yo, kuna mtu anauliza, pastor, what are you teaching? Divine life. I'm teaching divine life. The Bible says, enjoy life with the wife of thy youth. That is Ecclesiastes 9 verse 9. Angalieni tafadhali. Nataka tusonge, tutoke kwa ubatili. Tuingie kwa uungu. Ecclesiastes 9 verse 9. What does he say? Live joyfully with the wife whom thou lovest all the days of the life of thy vanity. 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 Unaishi kwa furaha na mke wako umependaye. Wewe unaelewa Kiswahili? Siku zote za maisha yako ya ubatili, maisha ya ubatili, hapa tu shida. So there is another level of life. Nifungieni mkono basi. Hallelujah. There is what? There is another dimension of life where I want us to never lose sight of. Come back to Matthew 22, you see. Verse 30. For in the resurrection, Matthew 22, 30. For in the resurrection, they neither marry nor are given in marriage, but are as the angels of God in heaven. So angels don't marry. Human beings do. Verse 31. Now I come to my message. But as touching the resurrection of the dead, have you not read that which was spoken unto you by God? So God has already spoken. God has already spoken clearly about resurrection. What did he say? Verse 32. He said, I am the God of Abraham and the God of Isaac and the God of Jacob. God is not the God of the dead, but of the living. Mungu si Mungu wa wafu. Ni Mungu wa walio hai. Ni Mungu wa walio hai. Kwa hivyo wakati umepoteza uzima katika Kristo, mtu ambaye hajaokoka, I must make this very clear to you. Mtu ambaye hajaokoka ni mali ya shetani. Lakini wale tuliokolewa, tukasamewa dhambi, tukaoshwa kwa damu ya msalaba,
tukabatizwa katika roho
mtakatifu na tukabatizwa katika mwili wa Kristo. Sisi tuna Mungu.
Nimesema sisi tuna Mungu. Is a God of the living. He is not the God of the dead.
And that is why he says, I am the God of Abraham. Why?
Because Abraham
is not dead.
Isaac is not dead. Jacob is not dead. These men are alive somewhere. They are alive somewhere. We are also alive in Christ. So you have the living God as your God.
Confess after me.
The living God is my God. Say it with authority. The living God is my God. Because I am not dead. I am not dead. I am alive in Christ. Say amen.
Whatever has been dying in your life,
I command it to come back to life. In the name of Jesus Christ.
Thank you, Lord. You see, the Bible says in Acts 17, I think 25. Acts chapter 17, verse 25.
He says, seeing that God is the one who gives life, breath, and all things. So our God is a giver of life.
He's a giver of life. I'm so happy today.
Because whatever has been this, or that is determined to die
in your life by the enemy,
it is not going to die.
Say yes, Lord.
Yes, whatever has been determined to die, it is not going to die in the name of Jesus.
He's the God of the living.
He's not the God of the dead.
So is your business, does it belong to God?
Then it is not going to die. Is a God of,
he's not the God of the dead, he's the God of the living.
So your marriage is not going to die.
We live because God is there, not because you are there. God is there.
You see, people are expecting so many Kenyans to die
because of COVID-19.
It is a lie. We are not going to die. We have a God.
Why are you not saying amen? Or you are expecting to die?
Never expect it. Never expect it.
I saw yesterday in some news somewhere that the Americans have accepted that the number of deaths that were recorded out of, that is because of COVID-19, it was a lie.
It was a lie. Somebody
was making money out of it. So that is why people expected the Kenyans to fall down and die. Here we are.
I said, here we are.
The Bible has a question in Isaiah 53 verse 1.
Who has believed our report?
So which report are you going to believe?
He says, who has believed our report? And to whom is the arm? The arm of the Lord be revealed. So the hand of God, which is the power of God,
is revealed to those who believe. To those who believe.
He is not the God of the dead.
And I can see all of you here, you are alive.
So I know who is your God.
That is why when Jesus rose from the dead in Luke chapter 24, when Jesus rose from the dead, there are those who went expecting to find him dead. They were disappointed. Just the way they did not find him dead, you will not be found dead. Do I have somebody who believes in God here? Luke 24. Luke 24. Now upon the first day of the week, it was on a Sunday, very early in the morning, they came to the grave, to the sepulchre, bringing the spices which they had prepared and certain others with them. They were carrying what? Spices. Badala wasitumie kwa chakula, walikuwa naletea Yesu wamupake. And they found the stone rolled away from the grave. And they entered in and found not the body of the Lord Jesus. Very clear. Wakati walipoingia, wasione mwili
wa weka jina yako hapo. Unaona hujasema.
You know, the expectation of Satan is that you die. But Jesus has already come that we might have life. And have it more abundantly. Change your mentality about life. You are not going anywhere. You are very young. I said you are very young.
And you have a purpose to fulfill.
I cannot die at this time. Very young. I have over 35 years preaching the gospel. Active 35 years that I have not touched. Preaching. Teaching from Luke chapter 24. Verse 24 now. Read verse 4. Verse 4. And it came to pass, as they were much perplexed thereabout, behold, two men stood by them in shining garments. Everybody, verse 5. And as they were afraid, and bowed down their faces to the earth, they said unto them, what did were they taught? Why seek ye the living among the dead? Are you among the dead? Shall no.
Yes, you are not among the dead.
So you can't be found where the dead are found. Never. You have shifted levels. You have changed position. Mahali watu walikuacha na wakakupanga, hapo sio mahali watakupata. Divine life will position you this time around.
Divine life will position you.
See life, not death. See life is not the god of the dead. It's the god of the living.
Sasa huo uzima sio tu wa mwili peke yake.
Ona uzima
kwa kazi ya mikono yako.
Ona uzima kwa watu wenu wote mahali walipo. Ona uzima Kenya. Ona uzima Kenya.
You see, Ezekiel was taken into a valley
of bones, dry bones.
And then he was asked by God, can these bones live? He said, you know it. Then God said, just prophesy.
Speak life. So where you want to see life,
Just speak it.
You say life in my business, life in my family, life in Kenya. Because the power of life and death is in your tongue.
Don't believe. You see, if you see somebody famous, now being announced that he has been affected or infected with the COVID-19, don't say, if so and so has been affected, I am the next one. No, you are not such a stupid man.
You are not foolish. Why? You are not supposed to think about it. You are not supposed to think about it.
Because just imagine one of our brothers here fearing that he can be pregnant.
One of our brothers
fearing that he can be what? Expectant. That is madness.
Forget about death. Forget about death. Because we were liberated by Christ from death.
Hebrews chapter 2 verse 14.
Hebrews chapter 2 verse 14. God is real. Hebrews 2:14. For as much then as the children are partakers of flesh and blood, he also himself took part of the same.
That everybody,
that through death,
the death of Christ,
he might destroy him that
had, that is past tense,
that had the power of death.
And that is who? The devil. So devil used to have.
He used to have power
over death. That is, he had the power of death. He was able to kill. But now,
he cannot. I say he cannot. Hallelujah. I say he cannot kill you.
He has not that power anymore.
He has no such authority anymore.
Then verse 15, he says,
and deliver them who through fear of death.
And the light is fear of death.
So what does he use?
Please talk to me.
What does he use? He uses fear of what?
Of death. He uses media. He uses journalists
to spread fear.
To show you that there are bugs that have been brought to put dead bodies. Watangojea bure. You know why I'm speaking like this?
God confirms the words of his servants. He performs the counsel of his messengers. Kenyans are not going to die. Shout amen. I say Kenyans are not going to die. Our God is real.
Believe it. Believe it. The one who had the power, who used to have
the power of death,
has been destroyed.
So he cannot use
viruses.
He cannot use
bacteria.
He cannot use road accident. He cannot use
floods.
He cannot.
Now, believe this and say with me.
Say, Satan will use nothing to destroy my life.
Yes. He's not going to use
hunger.
No hunger is coming. No flood is coming. No corona here.
Unless you carry that reality in you,
utabakia kwa uoga. Watu wamekoa miaka na miaka. Siku hizi kila mtu ameacha kukoa. Hii kanisa hakuna mtu amekoa. Kutoka turudi
Tuesday, nobody.
Kila mtu ameifunika. Kuna mtu anataka kukoa. Akikoa anaenda kwa uwanja. Listen, verse 15.
And deliver them.
We were delivered.
Deliver them. All through fear of death
were all their lifetime
subject to bondage.
Fear is a bondage. Don't fear.
Don't fear to be poor. It can't happen.
It can't happen. He became poor for us. He became poor. Don't fear. Don't fear. There are pastors all over this world who for many, many years they have been preaching that though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I shall fear no evil. Na sasa wamefunga makanisa. Umenyamaza? Si wamefunga?
Wengi wamefunga.
And for many, many years they preach to people
that though I walk under the valley,
saa hizi tutembee katika uvuli sasa.
Though I walk under the shadow,
or that is in the valley of the shadow,
I shall fear no evil, for thou art with me. God is with you. He says, thy rod
and thy staff,
they comfort me.
We are blessed.
I say we are blessed of God.
Jehovah will keep you. And listen, don't fear, because even if you die, the Bible says to live
is Christ, and to die is a gain.
So why are you fearing to make profit? To die is gain. Kufa ni faida. Hebu sema hivyo. Mbona usemi hiyo? Ushayo na mtu amelia kwa sababu ametengeneza pesa nyingi. Ati ame make profit. Nobody cries.
I want us to operate in the realm of divine life, knowing that Jesus has imparted life
to us.
He's not the God of the dead. Is the God of the living,
and we are alive in Christ. Colossians chapter 3 verse 4. Colossians chapter 3 verse 4. This is the truth. Colossians chapter 3 verse 4.
The Bible says, when Christ, who is our life? Christ is our life.
Christ is our life.
He is not going to be our life. He has already become
our life. He has already become our life. So is our God.
He is our God. He is our God.
1 Corinthians 6.
He is our God.
Verse 19.
1 Corinthians 6, 19 and 20.
1 Corinthians 6, 19 and 20. It says, what?
Know ye not that your body is the temple of the Holy Ghost which is in you?
So the Holy Ghost is where?
Is in you,
which ye have of God,
and ye are not your own. Wewe sio wako. Wewe ni wa mwenyewe. Na huyo mwenyewe
atakulinda. Wewe sio wako mwenyewe.
Wewe ni mali ya, mali ya, mali ya Mungu. Verse 20, because you are bought, he says,
for ye are bought with a price. Therefore, glorify God in your body and in your spirit.
Why?
Which are God's.
So you don't own yourself.
You belong to God.
And is the God of the living,
is not the God of the dead. The desire of my heart is that your eyes will open and you will see this realm of life.
Uone upeo wa uzima. Uone.
Uone uzima.
Usione mauti. Deuteronomy chapter 30 verse 15. He says, see, see,
I have set this day before you life
and death,
blessing and the curse.
You, it is set before you.
Ni kitu kimewekwa mbele yako. Ni wewe uchukue
ama uachane nayo. Uzima uko hapo. Uzima uko hapo.
It is upon you to choose. And then,
finally, reading the last scripture in this service, I read like this because I want you to carry life.
Revelation chapter 20. Revelation chapter 20, verse 2 and 3. Revelation chapter 21, verse 2 and 3.
And I, John, saw the holy city,
New Jerusalem.
He saw it. He saw it.
Coming down from God out of heaven,
prepared as a bride adorned for a husband.
He saw it coming down.
Are you there? Then what happened in verse 3?
And I heard a great voice out of heaven saying, behold, the tabernacle of God
was, shall, yes,
is with man, and he will dwell with them, and they shall be his people. And God himself shall be with them and be their God. So your God is here.
Mungu wako akuji ako. Akaribia shafika.
Anasema watakuwa
watu wangu.
Watakuwa watu wangu.
Naye atakuwa Mungu wetu.
That is how life is supposed to see.
Ona Mungu akiwa mahali uko. Ona Mungu. Ona Mungu.
Be conscious of God.
Yani uwe na ule utayari ya kwamba Mungu wako hapa pamoja na wewe. Usianze kuona kifo. Ona Yesu.
Usione mauti. Ona upako. Ona uwepo wa Mungu. Ona mamlaka ya Kristo
ikiwa imekulinda. Because the scripture is clear. And I saw heaven open. Then he says, and then I heard a great voice say, behold, the tabernacle of God is with man. Akwabanasisi. Akwabasai. Kile sio kazi yake kwa mwili wako. I curse it forever in the name of Jesus. No virus has power to get into your body. The name of Jesus. Thank you, Lord. I overcome the spirit of fear. Fear, you are gone forever. The name of Jesus. You never received the spirit of fear. But to receive the spirit which is of power, and sound mind, there is no room for fear. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. We serve such a wonderful God. Peace be with you. Peace be with you. Shalom, shalom, shalom. Tusimame basi. Shindano. Wale wameshaenda hospitali ukadungwa shindano. Au kudungwa na ikaachwa. Unadungwa na inatolewa. Unaachwa na ndawa mwili. Iyo umedungwa kwa saa hii imetosha. Praise the Lord. Ebu wave yule rafiki yako usimukaribie. Nikumuheshimu. Wana sifi. Umemusalimia mtu hapa. Wave at that great woman, great man. Hallelujah. The tabernacle of God is where? It's with man. Lift up your hands and just worship him. From the rising of the sun to the going down of the same, the name of Jesus to be glorified. In the name of Jesus Christ, Jehovah, we worship you. Jehovah, we magnify you. We honor you, Jesus. We honor you. You are wonderful, Son of God. You are wonderful, Son of God. Worship him. You live forever, Son of God. Thank you for life everlasting. Thank you because you are the God of the living and you are not the God of the dead. I'm alive in you. I am alive in you. Yes, I am alive in you. I am alive in Christ. Yes, Jehovah. Somebody worship him again. Worship him this day. Jehovah, you are holy and mighty. You are glorious and faithful. You reign, you reign, you reign, you reign, Lord. Yes, you are here together with us. The tabernacle of God is with man. Oh yes, the tabernacle of God is with man. He is our God and we are his people. The blood of Jesus has made it so. The Holy Spirit has sealed it. Thank you, Jesus. Hakika wema na sofadhili. Confess it. Sing it.
Sofa Uratawili Nitaka Kani wako Ando Siku zote Na maisha yangu
Hakika
Hakika Wema na sofani Titani Uata mimi
Confess those words, hallelujah.
Nitaka nyumbani baba ana siku zote na maisha yangu
ikiviwa
na glory we worship you one Lord you are worthy to be praised.
We give you all
the glory.
We give you the glory.
We worship you, Lord. You are worthy to be praised. We give you all the glory. We worship you, Lord. To be praised. In your glory, we worship you alone. You are worthy to be praised.
Father, we give you all the glory. We give you all the praise. You are the Alpha and Omega. Yes, you are the one who was dead, but now you are alive forevermore. And you have the keys of hell and death. Oh, Jesus. Jesus, we thank you. Can you celebrate the one who rose from the dead? His name is Jesus. Are you really celebrating the Master, the King of Kings, the Lord of Lords? Thank you, Father. Thank you, Jesus. Father, we thank you for this third service. We ask you for more grace to serve you in the next one. In Jesus' name it is done. Shangilia huyu Yesu, mwana wa Mungu aliye hai. You can have your seat. You have the victory. I say you can have your seat, you have your victory. Those are words from the Holy Spirit. I say you have your victory. Thank you, Jesus. Prepare your offerings very quickly. We are giving at the same time. Tithe and offerings, the same time. So don't have your offering in your pocket or in your handbag or in your head. You may be thinking that you are giving. Those who are watching this service online, our information is there. You can give via M-Pesa. You go to your M-Pesa, buy goods and services, Lipa na M-Pesa. Even us who are inside here, and you have your offering in your, that is in your M-Pesa account, give now. Get out your phone and we do what we are supposed to do. And listen, we are in the process of buying our land. We have never stopped. We have never stopped. And that is why you are supposed to give every day, no matter how much you have.
You give daily. You can give 50 shillings. You can give 1,000 daily. You can give 500 shillings daily. Because that is the number we are using. And again, you have the information. Everybody in this church has the information of our Word Temple Church of God development account. You have it, and if you don't, if you cannot remember, you remember that yellow karatasi tulikuwa tunawapatia. Yangu sijapoteza, you know, watu wanapotezanga zile vitu. Vitu hawafai ku. Yangu ndio hii. Kama haukupoteza simu, hii ilipotea namna gani? So use this information, and we give daily. At least something daily. Blessed Father, in the name of Jesus, accept our tithes today, our first fruits, our offerings. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Listen, as you come to give, we don't have Wi-Fi here inside here. We don't have Wi-Fi here. Every service is online. Na kila service tunainunulia bundles za kuirun the way we are running it. So kama hauna bahasha, naona deacons wameketi, naona mtu anaenda kujichukulia bahasha. Kama una bahasha nionyeshe kwa mkono. Hauna na unataka. So I don't know why you are sitting. Na unaenda pole pole sana. Mzee mbiti. Hakuna mtu amefikisha miaka 58 kwa hii kanisa, pigieni Yesu makofi. Nyosha tena mkono utaonekana. Tusirudie makosa. Kwa hivyo jiandae. Kwa hivyo nilikuwa nasema hatuna wifi hapa. Kama town tuko nayo. We only pay once. Lakini hapa hatuna. Kwa hivyo ukitoa, ukilipa fungu la 10 na utoe sandaka. Utoe sandaka ingine, uwekelea hapa. Mahali nimesimama hapa. Useme pastor, hiyo ni ya, hii service ambayo inafuatilia. Pia ikue online, ilipiwe. Watu waone wa ambao hawawezi kufika hapa. Kwa hivyo, God bless. Remember, endelea kuweka mask. Endelea kuoga mkono. Na usioge mkono bila kuoga mwili. You know, ni makosa sana. Yani wewe una sanitize mikono lakini huwa hauogangi. Utaoga sana ubakie mweupe kutoka hapa kuenda mbele. Kutoka hapa hivi kuenda mbele ubakie brown. Hii mwili ingine ibaki ikiwa iko sawa. Tusimame. Kwa hivyo umesikia vile nimesema? Kama una 1,000 kuja uweke hapa. Wale tuko mwisho hivi kuja tutoe sandaka. Wale tuko hivi. Alafu ukianza kuenda nje, you sanitize your hands on your way out. Na ukumbuke asubuhi kuna ibada hapa na lunch. Na Wednesday School of Ministry, usikose kufika hapa. God bless you. God bless you. Hiyo ibada ingine inaendelea, inaanza immediately, inaanza saa 5. Ni ya saa 5 mpaka saa 6. Kwa hivyo na usisimame, sababu watu ambao wanangojea kuingia ibada wamesimama kwa mlango. Mlango ikifunguliwa toka nje. Mlango ikifunguliwa toka nje. Usiwachwe hapa ndani. Usiwachwe. Wale watu wanafaa kuachwa hapa ndani ni Elijah, Moses, Apostle Paul, wale ambao kwa sasa walituacha kimwili.